Good morning, everybody. Hello and welcome to our next webinar with the topic Free at Home System Assess Point 2.0. My name is Thorsten Reibel. Together with me is Martin Bichari at Buschega in Lüdenscheid. Martin will present today, as well as our product manager for these products. Christian Krupper is with us. He will help us in answering your questions. So let me hand over to Martin right now. He will start with his presentation. Just a moment, please.
Yes, good morning also from my side. Thank you, Thorsten, for the introduction. Yes, my name is Martin Vichari, and yeah, the topic today is the System Access Point 2.0. So we have a new System Access Point for our Free at Home system, and I will present you some information, what is new, what is not new, what you have to know about the new System Access Point, what new features we have, and so on. So I prepared a small presentation. I think today also we won't need the whole 60 minutes. I think after 30 or maybe 40 minutes, we should be done with everything. Yes, and I will start now with the presentation. So the topic today is Free at Home. As I said, the new System Access Point, which will be released next year. So first of all, I will give you some general information, some background information about the motivation, why we need a new System Access Point. Yeah, then we will see what is new, what is not new, and yeah, some important information, what you have to know in case of replacement, do you have to replace the old one, and so on. Okay, so first of all, a short introduction. So let's have a look at the system in general, first of all. So I think all of you know the Free at Home system itself. We have different components in our system, so wired components and also wireless components. We have services like the remote access available. We can now integrate different third-party services. And yeah, for all this functions and for all these features, the System Access Point is responsible for. So the System Access Point is also more or less the heart of our system, and so the most important device of our system. Yeah, why it's so important? So let's take a look at some points. So first of all, we need the System Access Point really in every installation. So without the System Access Point, there won't be a Free at Home installation, so very important. It provides a visualization, so for operation, first of all, but we also have the interface for commissioning. This is also provided by the System Access Point. Then we have third-party integrations available, like Sonos, Philips Hue, and so on. It enables the usage of the cloud service, so for remote functions, for remote control, so functions like geofencing, for example. And last, it integrates also other ABB systems, so for example, the React system. So you see a lot of important functions here, and for all these functions, the System Access Point is responsible. That's why the System Access Point is so important for us. When we look into the past, what happened the last year? So we started with Free at Home in 2014, so 4.5 years ago now. In this time, we only had 64 devices for the system available. In 2016, we started then with the Free at Home wireless system. Here, so we had 64 additional devices, and we also had a new System Access Point with the Wi-Fi functionality, so with the wireless functionality. Yeah, and in the last years, we all in all provided 16 firmware updates. We are with new features, with bug fixes, of course, and all of them, of course, also free of charge. Yeah, firmware updates included also the integration of third-party services. So we see Philips Hue, we see Sonos, Alexa, and so on. So a lot of new features we brought into the system the last years. Yeah, so you see, Free at Home, all in all, and you also know that, became in the last years a really comprehensive and complete solution for our customers, so in residential buildings. But we also have to say that these features are, however, taxing the resources of the Free at Home system access point, so from processing and from the memory. And so we said, okay, we have to introduce a new hardware also for laying the foundation to have a continuous improvement, because we came to our limits slowly. So we said, okay, we need a new system access point with better hardware, with more power, let's say. Yeah. So this is how the new system access point looks like. So you can see we have a new design here, so it's a little bit more smaller, that you you can directly see this. So first of all, what is new now? Most important point maybe is that we can now support up to 150 devices, so wired and wireless devices combined. So you can of course do all wired, all wireless, or again mix the devices. I will tell you a little bit later more details about this new topology. Yeah, as you can see, and what I also mentioned, we have a smaller design, maybe also a little bit more aesthetical. What is also new, we have now an external power supply, so a little bit easier for the installation. I will show this also later with more details. We have different mounting options now, so especially with the external power supply that we can use now, we can just mount it on a table, for example, and we also have a DIN rail mounting type possible now. We have two USB ports at the new system access point, at the moment without functionality, but they are already available, so for further applications, but we don't have information about what will be concretely done with the in USB sticks at ports at the moment. And the system access point now can be connected also to the 5 gigahertz Wi-Fi. So in the past, and with the old one, we could only connect to the 2.4 gigahertz Wi-Fi network. Now the 5 gigahertz network is also available. Yeah, a better processor, what I just said. So you can see we have now a 1.2 gigahertz dual core processor, up from a 400 megahertz single core, and we have now 512 MB RAM, so also way better than the old one. Yeah, what is the same? We can still use wired and wireless, of course. The system access point is still the heart of our system, so it's the central point, and we need it in every installation, especially for the initial commissioning. So this is still the same. So let's have a look at the scope of supply. So what do you get when you order the system access point? So first of all, of course, the system access point itself. You get a mounting plate and also strain relief. This one you can connect on the back of the system access point. We will also show you. Yeah, some screws and dowels, and this is here the new plug-in power supply that you can see. Is also available with every order and every package of the new system access point. And also the VAGO adapters for bus connection, and if you want to power it with the yellow and white wire of the bus cable, also a second VAGO adapter available. I will show you this also in one of the next slides. So let's have a closer look at the system access point now. So first of all, we only have one button now available on the top side. So this button is for change the installation mode and for resetting the device. You have then on the right side a small LED here, and this LED is visualizing the status of the system access point. So if the LED is white, the system access point is connected to the to existing network. Blue means it provides its own network for commissioning when you're on site, for example. And if you change the mode with one click, so you have one button here to change the mode of the system access point, then it's blinking in orange. Then on the bottom side, so this is the bottom side of the system access point, we have now the power supply connector for the external plug-in. We have the two USB ports, as I said, without function at the moment, but for further applications. Then the LAN plug, and you can connect here also the external antenna for the FreeAtome wireless. Yeah, this is the backside of the device. So first of all, we have now four of these rubber feet
optional, da steht
on the
optional,
back.
ja,
This is
ein
for
bisschen
table mounting
extra.
Important. And as you can see, the connections for the bus wire and also for when you power it with the white and yellow cable of the bus cable, then this is the second option how you can power the system access point. So from powering side, you see it's a little bit easier with the new system access point. You have now the option with the external plug-in on the bottom side or powering it here with the bus cable on the back side. What you also might already see is now that there is no need for opening the system access point anymore and also no option to open it anymore. So in the past you had to open it, for example, to find the password for the Wi-Fi. Here now all information are printed on the back side, so you don't have to open it anymore, and there is also no directly option to open the system access point anymore. Yeah, very short, the dimensions. So as I said already, and you can also see, it's a little bit more more slimmer and smaller than the old one. From the thickness, it's more or less the same. I think 1 millimeter less than the old one, but more or less same size. This is how it looks like when you use the mounting plate on the back, on the back side. Maybe a closer look at the mounting options itself. So we have now three different options for mounting, as I said. Tabletop, first of all. So in general, for wireless installation, when you don't have the bus cable anyway. So for renovations or modernization projects where you use the wireless devices, then this might be a good solution. So here for this cases you would also use the external power plug and just let it on the table, for example. And therefore we also have this rubber feet, so no slipping from the surface and no scratching from the surface. This is also important. Yeah, next the wall mounted. So for the wall or on top of a VDE flush mounted installation box. And last the DIN-rail mounted. Here we have also some pictures for you. So
ja.
If you want to go with the DIN-rail mounting type, then you have to buy one another item. So the DIN-rail adapter looks like this. But please have in your mind that this is not the final version here. The final version will be in black. So this is just an sample. So please have this in your mind that the final adapter will be black. But also very easy to use, so you can just clamp it on the DIN rail and then put the system access point on it. So also very, very easy to use. Okay, next the external adapter that we have available now. So with every system access point that you will order, that you then you will get also this power supply. And we have here, of course, different adapter plugs for the different installation habits. So when you order the ABB version, then you will get three different plugs. So the power supply is and the plugs can be changed. They are separated, and then you can connect the right plug that you need for the adapter. So we have now the ABB version with three different types: type C, G, and I. Then we have one ABB version for the US market with the type A, and of course one Bushnell branded version, and here you only get the European type C. So please have this also in your mind that when you order the Bushnell version that you will only get one plug here. For the ABB version, there are three different plugs in that you can use. So this is also the first option how you power the system access point, so with the port on the back side, and then you connect this plug, or as we said, you can also power it with the bus cable. So we mentioned now most important points, but in general we need of course 24 volt for the system access point. So as we can see, the power adapter, or we can use the white and the yellow wire of the bus cable. So this is maybe the more pleasing solution when you mount it on the wall or you mount it in the cabinet. Here we also recommend then to use the ABB CPD 24 power supply, and with this power supply you can then also power additional 4.3 inch panels, for example. So this should be the more pleasing solution when you plan a new house, a new project with wires. Then this might be the best solution. So next important topic, and also, as I said, maybe the most important new feature is here about the system size limitations. So I already said we can use now up to 150 free at home devices. So not 64, not 128 anymore. Now it's 150. The 150 devices can be all wired, all wireless, or any mix of wired and wireless devices. What is important now? If you use more than 64 devices, then you have to use a second bus power supply. So with less than 64 wired devices, one is enough. With a second one, you need, with more than 64 devices, then you need the second power supply. When you mount the second, or when you install the second power supply, you can directly install it in parallel to the first one. This is also new. So you don't have to think about restrictions or something like this. Both power supplies may be directly installed in parallel. And what is also very important, there are no other constraints in terms of minimum cable length between the supplies. So from this view, the installation becomes also a little bit more easier and definitely more comfortable. So you can offer your customer, of course, more devices in his installation if he needs it, and also the installation here is a little bit easier. So already the last topic is regarding the upgrades. So further firmware updates, and if you replace it, what happens, what you have to think about. So first of all, what is important, all backup files made on the old system access point can be used also with the new system access point. So in any case of replacements, an old backup file can be used, and you don't have to create all the floor plans and the functions and the linkings one more time. So you can definitely use it. Of course, when you have really, really old backup files, maybe from 2014 or 15, so first generation, then of course there might be problems. But if you have more or less the latest firmware version and not so old installation, then all backup files will be working. What is also important now, at the moment, there is no reason why you should replace the old one. So don't be afraid that you have to change all system access points in your installation now. This is not necessary. So all following firmware updates will be available for both system access points, so for the new one, of course, but also for the old one. And there will be also only one file with the newest firmware on the Buschjäger catalog available. So you just always download the file from the site, and you can import it into both system access points. So you don't have to be scared that the old one won't be supported anymore. At the moment, all applications and new features which will come and software updates will be also available for the old one. So also we plan some new features for next year. Also these features and integrations which will come will also be available for the old system access point. But what I can say already, if you have bigger installations with a lot of devices, with a lot of actions, functions, time profiles, and so on, then the new one is really from the processor side and from memory side, it's a lot better or way better to work with it because it's faster and more reliable. So this is there is a difference that you really feel also when you work with the new one. Yeah, last very short, the article codes and so on. So here, first of all, the ABB and the Buschjäger version. As I said, the DeanRail adapter is an additional item that you have to order. Here also available then in ABB and in Buschjäger brand. And the question, when will the new system access point be available? So with the first wave, so the first step, we will start with next year. So hopefully, we hope that it will be available end of January or latest in February. So for some countries, some certifications are still pending, but the plan is still end of January or February. And the old one will be phased out, of course. At the moment, you can still order him, but in Q2 will be the old one will be phased out then. Then you can only order the new system access point. But please don't forget, the old one will be still supported at the moment, so the firmware updates will be still available also for the old one. So this was everything from my side, I guess. I think I can hand back to Thorsten now, and if you have any questions, you can ask them.
Yeah, thank you, Martin. Thank you for this, yeah, clear and also focused presentation. Then allow me to go to the final two slides I have here in my presentation. As always, a preview to our next, yeah, or further seminars here in Heidelberg, mainly the certified courses, basic course, advanced, and tutor, and two basic course as well as this year, also next year. And so as always, look in our training database to see what all is available, not only the certified trainings. Preview to the next webinar, this will be for sure next year. So this was our last webinar, number 13 this year, but on the 23rd of January 2019 we will continue again in the direction of Free at Home, because we talk about Secure at Home, the security solution which can be linked to Free at Home. So we have now a new status here. It's coming now, and we would like to go in some more details of the system. It was already presented during this year a bit as a first overview, but now it's really coming, and more detailed information then next year. Thank you to all of you for all your participation during the year. There is still a question regarding receiving the presentation and the video. Yes, of course, as always, we send our feedback email with the presentation from today. Yeah, see you next year. Merry Christmas and Happy New Year. Bye bye, ciao.